Hello, my dear students. Hope you all are fit and fine. Welcome to your English class. Today, we are going to study chapter number 3, Peter Madison. So, students, this is a story about a puppet whose name is Pinocchio. Now, let's have a look at this picture on your screen. You can see a puppet here. Puppet basically means any figure or doll which can be moved with the help of strings. So let's start our interesting story. Chapter number 3, Bitter Medicine. So students, as usual, there is an activity given at the beginning of this chapter also. And according to this activity, you have to think of any time when you were ill and you had to stay in bed and you have to take medicines and all that. So is just a kind of remembrance which you have to make. So let's begin our chapter from the next page. First I will read it and after then I will explain it. Let's start. Now read how Pinocchio the puppet behaved when he had to take some bitter medicine. Storyteller: Pinocchio is a wooden puppet. He has many adventures. In this story, he is very ill. The Blue Fairy is trying to make him well. So students, the first few lines of the chapter gives us the introduction of Pinocchio. And Pinocchio is a wooden puppet. Puppet, as I told you earlier also, puppet means a doll or any figure that can be moved by pulling strings. So Pinocchio is a wooden puppet and he has many adventures. Adventures means exciting experiences. He had many exciting experiences, but in this story he is very ill. He is not well, and the Blue Fairy is trying to make him well. And there is Blue Fairy who is looking after that sick Pinocchio. The Blue Fairy is trying to make Pinocchio well again. Let's read further. Fairy: You have a high fever. She gives him a half glass of medicine. Drink this and you will be well. Pinocchio makes a face. Is it sweet or bitter? Fairy: It is bitter, but it will do you good. Pinocchio: If it is bitter, I will not have it. Fairy: Drink it and I will give you a lump of sugar to take away the taste. Pinocchio: Give me the lump of sugar first, and then I will drink that nasty bitter medicine. So students, these lines tell us that Pinocchio, a wooden puppet, is suffering from high fever. He is having very high fever, and Blue Fairy is trying to give him medicine so that he can become well. So Blue Fairy gives him a half glass of medicine, and she asks Pinocchio to drink that medicine. To which Pinocchio replied that first tell me whether this medicine is sweet or bitter. Bitter means something which is very sour or which is not sweet, which does not have any good taste. So Pinocchio asked the fairy that first tell me whether this medicine is sweet or it is of unpleasant taste. To which fairy replied that it is bitter, it is not having good taste, it is not sweet, but it will make you good, it will make you well. But on hearing this, that the medicine is bitter, Pinocchio denied to have that medicine. Pinocchio said that if it is bitter, I am not going to drink this medicine. To which fairy said she tried to convince Pinocchio to have that medicine by saying that just drink this medicine and after that I will give you a lump of sugar to take away the taste. Lump means a student's chunk, or you can say a part of something. So fairy said that just drink it. She tried to convince Pinocchio by saying that just drink this medicine and after that I will give you some sugar so that your bitter taste can be replaced by a sweet one. And to which Pinocchio replied that okay, first give me the sugar, give me some sugar to eat, and after that I will drink this nasty bitter medicine. Nasty means very bad. So Pinocchio said that first give me some sugar. First of all, I will eat that, and after that, I will drink this bad, very bad and bitter medicine. Now let's read further. Chanda page. Fairy, do you promise me? Pinocchio, yes. Fairy gives Pinocchio the sugar. He puts it in his mouth and crunches it. Pinocchio, licking his lips. It would be fine thing if sugar were medicine. I would take it every day. Fairy, now keep your promise and drink your medicine. You will get better. Pinocchio, it smells it. Wow, it is too bitter. I can't drink it. Gives the glass to Fairy. Fairy, how do you know when you have not even tasted it? Pinocchio, I can imagine it. I know it from the smell. I want another lump of sugar first, and then I will drink it. So these lines tells us that when Pinocchio demanded for sugar first before having that medicine, then Fairy asked him that, do you promise me that you will have your medicine after having this sugar? To which Pinocchio replied, yes, I will have my medicine. First give me the sugar. So after taking promise from Pinocchio, Fairy gives him the sugar and he eat that sugar. After eating that sugar, he relishes the taste of sugar, and he said to Fairy that it would be very fine, it would be very good if sugar were a medicine. I would be then having it every day. And after that, Fairy said to Pinocchio that, okay, now keep your promise. I gave you the sugar to eat. Now drink this medicine so that you will be better, you will be fine. So Pinocchio took the glass of medicine from Fairy's hand, and he smells it. And after smelling, he said to Fairy, oh, it's so bitter, it smells so bitter. I cannot drink this medicine. And he returns the glass to Fairy. To which Fairy said that, how can you say it is very bitter when you have not even tasted it? Pinocchio said that, I can imagine it from the smell. If the smell is so bitter, just imagine how bitter the medicine would be. And no, I can't drink this. I want some sugar, some more sugar, and after that, I will drink this. So students, moving further, now let's read the next page. The fairy puts another lump of sugar in Pinocchio's mouth. She then gives him the glass again. Pinocchio, I can't drink it like this. Fairy, why? Pinocchio, because that pillow near my feet bothers me. Fairy, I will remove it then. Removes pillow. Pinocchio, I still can't drink it. Fairy, what is the matter now? Pinocchio, the door is half open. It bothers me. Fairy, I will close it then. Closes the door. Pinocchio, bursting into tears. I will not drink that bitter medicine. No. Fairy, then listen now to what you will be without your medicine. So students, here we see that Fairy gives Pinocchio sugar for the second time also. And after having that, Pinocchio is still denied to have that medicine. And he started making various excuses. For example, he said to Fairy that I cannot drink this medicine because that pillow near my feet is bothering me. It bothers me. Bothers means something which annoys you or which causes trouble. So he said that I cannot drink the medicine because that pillow bothers me. After which the Fairy removed that pillow so that he may feel comfortable and have that medicine. So he made a new excuse. After that, he said that the clothes is half open and I cannot drink this medicine and it is bothering me. So you can see that how funny, how lame excuses Pinocchio was making just to avoid that medicine. But Fairy wanted to give that medicine to Pinocchio. So she did everything to make Pinocchio comfortable. She removed that pillow, she closes the door, but still Pinocchio did not have that medicine, and instead he started crying. He burst into tears. Burst into tears means he started crying, and he said that I will not drink that bitter medicine. No, I will not drink. No, I will not drink. To which Fairy replied, okay then, listen to what you will be if you will not drink your medicine. Now let's read further. First storyteller.
Poor Pinocchio, thin as a pin, can't go out, just stays in.
Second storyteller. Poor Pinocchio, always in bed, only on soup and porridge fed.
First and second storytellers.
Poor Pinocchio, we knew him well, begin sobbing.
So the two storyteller is starting predicting. They started predicting about Pinocchio, and the first one said that you will become very thin. You will become so thin, just like a pin, and you will not be able to go out, and you will have to stay in your home only if you will not drink this medicine. Then the second storyteller told him that Pinocchio, you will be always on your bed, and you will have to eat so boring food such as porridge and soup. And then both the first and second storyteller combinedly said that poor Pinocchio, we knew you well, and if you will not drink this medicine, you will have to face difficulty in future.
And students, here a word sobbing is used in the last line, which means crying noisily or to cry with noise. Now let's move to the next page.
Pinocchio, is this real? Will this happen?
Fearing, I am afraid so.
Yes.
Pinocchio, give me that medicine. He takes the glass in both hands. He empties it in one gulp.
So these lines tells us that on hearing the predictions of the storytellers, Pinocchio become very worried. He become very much afraid, and he asked Fury that it is so. Is this real that if I will not drink medicine, I will have to stay in bed. I will become so thin, and I will have to eat so boring food such as porridge and soup. To which Fury replied, yes, it might be possible. On hearing Fury's reply, Pinocchio became more worried, and he suddenly took the glass of medicine from Fury, and he drank that medicine quickly. A word gulp is used here, which means swallow quickly. So he swallowed that medicine quickly by becoming worried with the wordings of the storytellers. So students, this was all in this story named Bitter Medicine. And this story also gives us a lesson. This story also teaches us the value or importance of medicine, that we should always take medicine on time whenever we are advised to do so. We'll meet you on the next turn. Till then, take care and keep learning.